The give is to Bell. And he's in. Touchdown, Houston. Le'Veon Bell. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Texans have cut it to within a score. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking. Beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best.
Put your foot on the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it, touchdowns.
They'll stick to the ground game with Gore. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given a little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
Back to throw, Semien. Right side, caught, Fedorowicz. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. 10 yards there, good enough for a Jags first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
To throw on second is Semien. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. They were looking to get into Kelvin Benjamin there, and it's third down. But not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I know you've been overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete.
Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jonathan Joseph, and they will take over at the 26-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is third down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bad result.
And now out comes Houston. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, not a chance. If they can put something together here, and I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. Do they want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
Yeah, they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral, also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Manning now on first down. Over the middle, complete. It's Gray. And he's brought down. A big one there for the Texans, 18 yards.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Throwing on first down is Manning. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted, and if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play, now it's second down. They'll give this to Bell running right. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack, and on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
The Texans on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. Working from the gun, Manning. It's caught, Jones. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And he'll get 4 there, down to about the 12-yard line.
I like the call. Inside the red zone, running the toss. Why? They want to get to the edges. They want to see if guys who don't normally make a lot of tackles are willing to actually do that. That usually means the guy's in the cornerback position.
They'll go again with Bell. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old-school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads. Bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through 3 quarters. No reason to lighten up now. They'll try and run it in with Bell. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
And that loss of yards there is not just on him. It's on the guys blocking for him. I mean, they're supposed to create some type of space or at least get a stalemate. They end up letting them through, and they ended up tackling him for a loss.
A give to Bell. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score 1 touchdown,
you want 2.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got 1, but was denied as he tried to get the 2nd one.
Here we go, 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. Here's Bell, and not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and what to do now on 4th and goal.
Now, this feels like old school football because this has turned into a good old-fashioned goal line stand. So on offense, what do you do now? Do you decide to run it or throw it if you go for it on 4th down?
Now Manning, gotta have this one. And that is caught. Touchdown, Texans. Sammy Coates from a yard out. And the Texans have taken the lead here in the 4th quarter.
Well, we've seen some lead changes, and it certainly appeared that one of these squads was in full control of the game, but that's not the case after that touchdown.
Now they erase a 2-TD deficit here to grab the lead. And this one through the uprights and good. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And the result, a Houston touchdown. Here's Tucker now out to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee. Jaguars offense as they get set to go again. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They tackle him almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars. Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. On first down, it's Gore. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down. Simeon going to rush his guys to the line. He'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Simeon in need of something big following that sack, facing third and long. He's back to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. Well, the screen gets 7, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll get it with just over 90 seconds to go in the ballgame. Desperation time for Simeon on fourth. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Give him 27 yards that time. And that'll be good for a Jacksonville first down. Back to throw. Got his man over the middle. This is quick. A good pick up there, a 22. First down now, but that clock rolling. They'll look to throw. Taken down. Willie Young in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. And with just over 40 seconds now remaining, he gets up and spikes it. This offense on third down today, they're hitting at just 30%, 3 for 10. They're looking at a third and goal here. Back to throw. It's complete. It's Gore. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had the play call on fourth and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And defensively, that might just seal a week one victory. And they've now made 2 trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in, and if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, if you're in the red zone, we're thinking we're giving up 3. We just want to give up 6. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment. But here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact. And as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Manning looking to throw it. He's going to look deep down the field. And got his man complete. A big gain there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? And sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day, opening game.